Okay, I thank you for being here. We're going to have a format, a little bit of a vigil. And so as we go along, we're not having any singing, and we're not going to have any community participation. So I is what you get. Name the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with all of you. My brothers and sisters, we believe that all ties of friendship and affection which knit us one throughout our lives do not unravel at death. Confident that God always remembers the good we have done and forgives our sins, let us pray, asking God to gather you. Lord our God, the death of our sister Jean recalls our human condition and the brevity of our lives on earth. But for those who believe in your love, death is not the end, nor does it destroy the bonds that you forge in our lives. We share the faith of your Son's disciples and the hope of the children of God. Bring the light of Christ's resurrection to this time of testing and pain as we pray for Jean and all of her family and for all those who love her. Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. We're blessing the holy water freeman. Reading from St. Paul to the Corinthians. We know that if our earthly dwelling and tent should be unraveled, we have a building from God, a dwelling not made with hands, eternal in heaven. So we are always courageous, although we know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord, for we walk by faith, not by sight. Yet we are courageous, and we would rather leave the body and go home to the Lord. Therefore we aspire to please Him, whether we are at home or away. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each one may receive recompense according to what he or she did in the body. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The Lord is my light and my salvation. The Lord is my light and my salvation. The Lord is my light and my help. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Before whom shall I shrink? The Lord is my light. Salvation. There is one thing I ask of the Lord, for this I long, to live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to savor the sweetness of the Lord, to behold his temple. The Lord is my light and my salvation. O Lord, hear my voice when I call. Have mercy and answer. It is your face, O Lord, that I seek. Hide not your face. The Lord is my light and my salvation. I am sure I shall see the Lord's goodness in the land of the living. Hope in Him, hold firm, take heart, hope in the Lord. The Lord is my light and my salvation. I'm going to ask you to stand, please, for the gospel. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said to his disciples, gird your loins and light your lamps, and be like servants who await their master's return from the wedding, ready to open immediately when he comes and knocks. Blessed are those servants whom the master finds vigilant at his arrival. Amen, I say to you, he will gird himself, have them recline at table, and proceed to wait on them. Should he come in the second or the third watch and find them prepared in this way, blessed are those servants. Be sure of this, if the master of the household had known the hour when the thief was coming, he would not have let his house be broken into. You also must be prepared, for in an hour you do not expect the Son of Man. Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. By the reading of this gospel, may our sins be blotted out. Be seated, please. Well, as you can tell, I'm doing a lot better than I did a year and a half or so ago when Doug died.
Yeah.
I got a phone call from Kathy. I think it was the 4th, the day after Bud had died on Thursday evening. I think it was Thursday evening, the 3rd. And I said, oh, Kathy, I don't know if I'm going to. I just had my hip go out. And so I was an immobilizer, short version of the story. I said, well, I'll see what I can do, maybe stop up. So I did on Sunday, stopped up with Isles and saw the family at the Western House. That was the extent what I was able to do for Bud. And I really hated it because Bud had asked me a couple of times, Bud, you're gonna be my hero. I said, yes.
I think he's here.
I think you're right. He's been around. He doesn't get. He never had a lot to say. He was always present. Jeanette Jean Bloom Ruschenberg, born in 1928. She's about 10 years older than I was, and died just the end of October. Married to Bud in 1949. I was just in grade school then, yet, I believe. We lived in the Harlan area, moved to Urbandale, and Bud died in 2019. I often went up to Madrid to visit with Gene and Bud. Of course, over the years I had gone to visit with Bud and Gene. What was the street they lived on?
Kennedy?
West
Kennedy? Was it in Madrid?
No, I'm talking about in Urbandale.
Oh, 66th Street.
Yeah.
Wilton Drive.
Yeah, that's it.
Wilton Drive.
Stop up there once in a while, see him over at Bud or Charlie and Darlene's as well. But I remember in the fall of 1955, I think it was, when I was going out for the basketball team of Panama, Iowa. And so I had talked with the, I was like six men on the five man squad. I said, the guys are planning to get flat tops. And I know Bud, or Bill Mischel is a good barber there in Panama, but I said, I don't think Bill knows how to give a flat top. So I said, I'd like to go over to Harlem and get a haircut over there. So I went over to Harlem, went on the east side of the square, went up the steps there and into the shop, and there was Bud. Now, I didn't really know Bud real well. I knew that we were a little bit related. But I got married and it was great. It was a great job. And that was just the beginning of a long tradition in which I had Bud as my barber for over almost 65 years. And I think that's some type of a record. I don't know how many of you have seen a magician or a barber for that long period of time. But I did enjoy it, the chance to see Bud, and they moved to Des Moines, I think it was in 1961. And I got to know the family a little bit better because you're going to have to help me out because I don't remember when it was. I was at the Dowling High School. Just a young kid, just barely turned 26, and Gary was a boarder at the old school. And so I was one of the youngest of the priests there. We had 25 priests at Dowling at the time. So Monsignor Nugent had pointed me. He said, Father Bob, I want you to be in charge of those boarders. We've got about five or six boarders here. And so Alan Vandenberg from Harlem, and Gary Rischenberg, and then there was Shaw, and there was, I forget the names of all of them. But anyway, I was in charge. I had to make sure to tuck them in the bed at night. make sure they weren't climbing outside, you know, in fall of the year, and I think it may have been when Gary was a sophomore, he went out to Portsmouth, and was involved in a movie accident, was killed, just south of Portsmouth there, right into the regular tracks and highway, the old highway 44. So when Senior Nugent asked me, since I was from the area out there and also in charge of the borders, I went out to Harlan, and so I attended and was representing Dowling at the funeral for Gary that fall. So it was a tough situation with Bud and Gene having just moved to Des Moines, I think, just in 61 or so. So having moved into Urbandale and not knowing a lot of people there, but I did represent and I got to know family a little bit better by the sad situation when that happened. It really was very tough on Bud and Gene, of course, the family as well. Gene loved to watch the birds eat there at the window there in the cedars. Gene was always there in her room when Bud would be giving me a haircut, and then I would go with the two of them. Each of them had their little carts.
Waters.
And we would make our way down to the room down there, and Bud would, in your sweetness and the other people, always had, he treated me really great. And many, many times Gene was there as well as we would go downstairs. So I give thanks for the opportunity for myself personally as being able to be part of the service here today. And one other thing besides Bud being my barber for the years, I also had the opportunity of being at the festival family. I don't think it was the Christmas Eve from 1964 up until this year. What's the plans for this year? I give thanks to all of you, though, that I did have my mass at my residence this morning, and I did remember Gene and all the family in my mass this morning as well. So I continue to keep reading my prayers as we come here to give thankfulness and great appreciation of the love of God on Gene and for all of us gathered here. So why don't we pray together the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Lord Jesus, our Redeemer, you willingly gave yourself up to death so that all of us might be saved and pass from death to life. We humbly ask you to comfort your servants in their grief and to receive Jean into the arms of your mercy. You alone are the Holy One. You are mercy itself. By dying, you unlocked the gates of life for those who believe in you. Forgive Jean any of her sins and grant her a place of happiness, light, and peace in the kingdom of your glory, where you live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Blessed are those who have died in the Lord. Let them rest from their labors, for their good deeds go with them. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual life shine. May she rest in peace. Amen. May her soul and all the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. May the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding. Keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son,